Good afternoon, children. Today we will start a new lesson from your book First Flight and from the part Glimpses of India. The lesson's name is Coorg. So open your book to page 90. Coorg. Coorg is coffee country, famous for its rainforest and spices. So we are talking about the lesson about Coorg, a place in South India, a beautiful place. Midway between Mysore and the coastal town of Mangalore sits a piece of heaven that must have drifted from the kingdom of God. This land of rolling hills is inhabited by a proud race of martial men, beautiful women and wild creatures. So the poet says that, the author, that Coorg is situated midway between Mysore and Mangalore, coastal town of Mangalore. And he describes it as a piece of heaven. It is so beautiful that he says that it must have drifted down from the kingdom of gods. It is so beautiful. This land of rolling hills is inhabited by a proud race of martial men. So land of rolling hills. Rolling hills, you can very well understand because we are from the northeast and we are also surrounded by rolling hills. And the people living there are said to be their proud race of martial men. Martial men having to do with war, warriors, beautiful women and wild creatures. Wild creatures, animals. Coorg or Kodagu. The other name of Coorg is Kodagu, also known as Kodagu. It is the smallest district of Karnataka and it is home to evergreen rainforest, spices and coffee plantations. Coffee plantations means coffee gardens. As we have tea plantations, or that way, Coorg is famous for its coffee plantation. And the evergreen rainforest covers 30% of this small district of Coorg. And during the monsoons, it pours. Pours means it rains enough. So much it rains that it keeps away many visitors. The season of joy begins from September and continues till March. So the best time to visit Coorg is from September to March. Okay, children? Otherwise, in the rainy season, it rains so much. So it is very difficult to go there. As we see in Kaziranga, there is a particular time during monsoon. Visitors at Kaziranga Wildlife Sanctuary is closed down. Nobody is allowed to visit. Similarly, Coorg also, people do not go there because it becomes difficult. But during September to March, the weather is perfect with some showers. Showers here means rain. Remember, letter to God, thrown in for good measure. Means it rains, it drizzles sometimes and it makes the weather more pleasant. The air breathes of invigorating coffee. The air is filled up with the fragrance of coffee. Invigorating, giving us vigor, livening us up. When we feel sleepy or lazy, we drink tea or coffee to invigorate us. That is it. Coffee estates, coffee plantations, coffee estates, coffee gardens, similar. And colonial bungalows stand tucked under tree canopies in prime locations. So this is it. Coffee estates and the coffee with their colonial bungalows. Bungalows means the residence, the houses. And why they are called colonial? Because during these plantations and things were established mainly by the Britishers. Okay. And they had colonized India. So the bungalows made by them are known as colonial bungalows with a typical style of slanting roofs, thatched and slanting roofs. And they tucked under the stand, means they are placed under such nice places, under the tree canopies in prime look corners. Canopy means what? Roof-like coverings that form shelter. Now, the tree canopies, it's not a roof of the bungalows, but surrounding the bungalows, there are many trees. So, and this is rainforest, big trees with plenty of leaves and all. So, it looks as though it is covering the houses. And they are situated in prime corners, in the best part of the coffee plantation. Prime here, you can see best actually. In this lesson, prime means best. Some of you may be mistaken that it is here and best. Here is meaning here in this lesson. Okay, children, I hope you have understood. This part describes the Coorg, the climate of Coorg and the people that lives here. So children, continuing with the lesson, the second part which describes the people of Kurg. The fiercely independent people of Kurg are possibly of Greek or Arabic descent. So it is believed that the people of Greek or Arab might have come down from, the people of Kurg might have come down from Greek or Arab. And there are two stories which gives a little proof that they might have come from Greece or Arab. Like, as one story goes, a part of Alexander's army moved south along the coast and settled here when return became impractical. These people married amongst the locals, and their culture is apparent in the martial traditions, marriages, and religious rites, which are distinct from the Hindu mainstream. So, to the theory that supports that they have come from Greece is that some armies, when Alexander came to conquer India, a part of his army, they came down to Alexander. I think all of you know, isn't it? In Hindi, he is known as the Sikandar. Okay. Few members of his army, they have traveled towards the south of India. They traveled along the coast, and then when their return became impractical. Means why impractical? They are not accustomed to the climate of India. During the monsoon season, what happens? All the rivers get flooded, flood everywhere, muddy flood, too much of rain. So it was not possible for them to move. They might have fallen sick. So they settled down here in this part of South India, Kurg. They settled down. And they married the local people. They married amongst the local people. And their culture is apparent in the martial traditions. Means after that, their culture, their religious rites, their marriage rituals and all those things are a bit different from the common Hindu rites and rituals. Okay? There is a somewhat similarity with the Greek rites and rituals, or the martial welfare traditions, means the warfare tactics and all. They are similar to the Greece, alright, to the Greeks. So it is believed that maybe these people have come down from Greece, alright. Then it is also believed that they may also be from Arab. They might have also come from Arab. So which theory supports this, that they have come from Arab? Their traditional dress, not their culture or anything, but their traditional dress. See, the theory of Arab origin draws support from the long black coat with an embroidered waist belt worn by the Kudavus, known as kufia. It resembles the kufia worn by the Arabs and Kurds. Okay? So, this is the long coat and this is the waist belt, which has some embroidery. And embroidery means design stitched with colorful threads. Okay, so this traditional dress which they wear is very much similar to the dress worn by the traditional dress of the Arabs and the Kurds. This dress is known as kupia in Kurg. Okay, and the dress worn by the Arabs is known as kufia. See the difference? Kupia and kufia, but they are very similar. But for this traditional dress, sometimes it is also believed that they might have come down from Arab and settled in Kurg. So we shall do till here today, children. Will not go much. I hope this part you have understood, and if you have not understood, you can please ask me. Thank you.